to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to Roy Orbison, and we are going to react to the song You Got It.
It is the first time single take honest reaction by both of us. Yeah. If you're new here or if it's your first time here, we give first time single take reactions almost every single time that we watch or listen to a song on this channel, on this platform. It's always honest, it's always spontaneous, pure, raw, genuine and impromptu. Our reactions are totally unscripted, including this little introduction now. Yeah. Totally unscripted. We say it as we think it or as we feel it while listening to the song. Soon as the song is over, we express ourselves. In no world we will ever pause a song. We listen to music in one go, maintaining the beautiful flow of the sound in our ears, uninterrupted, without pausing it. We listen to it as every music reviewer and essentially every music lover should listen to a song. So that's what we do. You can check out our Patreon page to learn more about us.
This is requested by Jay.
Yeah, it is a Patreon request. Patreon request, and you too can request reactions with us by checking out our Patreon page and choosing an available tire if there's one. Hope you're having a good time wherever you're joining us from in the world. Happy holidays to all of you. It's festive season in India. It's also festive season in the West, most
around
parts
the world, yeah.
Around the world. So hope you're having a great time with your loved ones or even at home if you're alone. I hope you're having a great time enjoying yourself and the festivities. It's been a different year for all of us.
Different year.
Quite different from most years that we've lived. So I don't need to get too much into detail about it. But yeah, let's hope you're having a great time. Let's get started. Roy Orbison, You Got It.
You got it.
Every time I look into your loving eyes, I see love that money just can't buy. One look about you tells me I'm your man. I live my life to be with you. No one can do the thing you do. Anything you want, you got it. Anything you need.
Wow, this is a masterpiece.
This is great. I don't know whether I've heard it or not, but it was so easy.
It was so easy.
Just few words and you got it.
I was thinking the exact same thing. I've heard this before. Because I don't remember it. But then how can it be so easy to get it?
It is way too easy.
It's just so beautifully crafted. The arrangement, the way it's sung. It sounds effortless the way he sings, but it's so difficult to sound the way he does. It's so beautiful. It's so rhythmic. It's so romantic. It's so beautiful. Wow. This is sweet. This is serene. It's upbeat at the same time, though I just said it's serene. It's actually upbeat. It's bubbly. It's cheerful. It's lively. It's interesting. It's fascinating. It's deep. It's thought-provoking. And at the same time, it's light, breezy and blissful. I love every single second of this song. This is a song that I think I'll listen to for ages to come. As long as I'm alive, songs like these will probably be on my playlist forever.
I liked it. It's not only about the way it's sung. It's not only about Roy Orbison and the way he was singing it, but also the music, also the richness in the music, the tune and everything. In today's time, for a song, one thing going makes the entire song sell. But here, everything was going at the same level. Everything was top-notch. Every person, every artist that was part of it was playing at his A game.
Maybe you caught onto something really big. You just said one thing that makes a song sell.
I know.
Maybe back then, when this song was probably created, maybe in the 50s, 60s or 70s, by the sounds of it, early 70s, that too, not late 70s.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the intention was not for it to sell alone. The intention was to please the listener. Give music that the listener will enjoy, will savor, will reflect upon for hours on end, will enjoy, will want to listen to again and again. Maybe that was the main intention in those days. So that's why everything fits together.
Everything is
when you have
perfect.
That real golden purpose and everything is right, that's why it's called the golden era, because the purpose was golden by itself. Everything was to keep it, you know, real, genuine and true to music. And this is a classic example of it.
This is great.
Roy Orbison, You Got It. This has to be one of the best songs I've heard this year, easily. It sounds simple. People will say, why? You know, if someone doesn't understand music or why I said it, they'll say, you know, he's saying it's one of the best songs that shows his taste. No, it shows your taste. It needs to be upgraded.
It obviously needs to be
looked at seriously.
You know, when I said one thing going for the song and then they sell it based on only on that, because now we have limited talent and people have to save. If they have two good things in a song, they will remove one of that because that is precious for them. They're going to use that for another song, another piece, because they have to sell something, right? It's more about salesmanship and it is more about marketing and more about money making,
more about the numbers.
Not the art. And back then, for an example, if there is a set made in the olden times, they would put everything that was perfect for the set, for it to look as grand as it could. But in today's time, people try to cost cut and do this and do that. Sometimes, you know, take a shortcut, do whatever makes it appear good. It may not be good from inside. So the cost cutting has gone too far and it has come into the art form as well. So the cost cutting happens there too, because next song also they have to make and I don't have much talent. I don't have much inspiration. So I have to use what I have right now, the ideas. So this was actually the golden era. I like this song. This made my day.
That's it for this one. Goodbye.